Nuclear power plants and coal-based thermal power plants have many things in common. They both convert heat energy into electrical energy. In coal-based thermal power plants, heat energy is produced by burning coal, which releases carbon dioxide and other harmful gases into our atmosphere. In nuclear power plants, heat is produced during the fission reaction, which does not release any harmful gases into the atmosphere. In today's video, we are going to see the working of the nuclear power plants. Hi, I'm Benila and you are watching The Learning Curve. The nuclear reactor is considered the heart of the nuclear power plants as nuclear fission takes place here. The commonly used fuel for fission reaction is uranium-235. The nuclear fission reaction is triggered by hitting this uranium-235 with neutrons from another source. When this excess neutron is added to the uranium-235, it becomes more unstable and splits into two smaller atoms, krypton-92 and barium-141. Along with these two atoms, three free neutrons were also produced during this fission process. These free neutrons split up some more atoms, which in turn releases more neutrons. This process continues again and again, and this will continue throughout the reaction material. This releases huge amount of thermal energy. This thermal energy is converted into electrical energy. Nuclear reactor uses uranium dioxide powder, which is 3 to 5% uranium-235, as the fuel material. Uranium-235 is highly radioactive. In order to eliminate the radiation hazards, the fuel element is loaded into long tubes. Several tubes are arranged in a bundle which is ready to be used in a nuclear reactor. Inside the nuclear reactor, these fuel rods are immersed in water which acts as a coolant. Since each fission produces three high energy neutrons, huge thermal energy is produced, which is far more than required by the nuclear power plant, and also it is dangerous. I have mentioned that water acts as a coolant, but that's not sufficient. So somehow we need to get rid of the excess neutrons. Materials like boron and cadmium are very good at absorbing neutrons. So rods made of these materials are placed inside the reactor. These are called control rods. It can be moved up and down to control the fission rate. The heat energy released during this fission reaction heats up the water in the reactor vessel, generating steam. This steam turns on the steam turbine, which is coupled with the generator that generates electricity. This is how the boiling water reactor works. There is another type of reactor called pressurized water reactor, which also works in a similar way with a minor difference. There also, the water in the reactor vessel heats up, but it is not allowed to boil or form steam. Even though the temperature of water exceeds the boiling point, the water doesn't boil. How is it possible? We all know that water boils at 100 degrees Celsius, but this fact is true only at standard atmospheric pressure. If the pressure increases, the boiling point of water also increases. In a pressurized water reactor, the pressure regulator keeps everything under high pressure. Even though the temperature of the water is very high, the water doesn't boil due to this high pressure. This extremely hot water is allowed to pass through the pipes into a steam generator. The hot water that flows through the pipe gives off its heat to the water present in the steam generator. The water in the steam generator is not pressurized. Therefore, the water in the steam generator starts boiling and the steam is generated. This steam turns on the steam turbine, which is coupled with the generator that generates electricity. The steam is then converted into water in the condenser by exposure to cold water. The output from the condenser is fed back into the steam generator. Nuclear fuel is typically used in a reactor for 3 to 5 years. The spent fuel rods are removed and safely stored in the cooling pools using robotic manipulators. That's all for today. Bye. See you in my next video.